Hi, welcome to the MAP tutorial, Alarm Configuration Management. In this video, we'll learn about the options offered by the MpAlarmX configuration. MpAlarmX allows us to influence the behavior and the properties of each alarm. Let's take a closer look at the MpAlarmX configuration. All user-defined alarms are listed here, and you can define the alarm name, which uniquely identifies the alarm within the program, as well as the alarm text. Instead of entering text directly, it's also possible to link to a text in the text system. The severity of the alarm is defined by the severity parameter. It's also possible to define how the alarm will behave in the application. This is done using the behavior parameter. There are two predefined types of behavior, edge and persistent. But what do they mean? Edge alarms are short-term alarms. You can think of them like an event. As soon as they are set, they're automatically reset. Examples of edge alarms would be things like recipe could not be loaded or message could not be sent. The alarm can then be acknowledged via either the HMI application or the control application. Persistent alarms remain active until a certain condition is met or until the state of an alarm changes. These alarms are set and reset manually. An example would be a temperature violation in a heating zone, where the alarm remains active until the temperature in the machine returns to normal, at which point it is reset via the application. The alarm can then be acknowledged via either the HMI application or the control application. Alternatively, it's also possible to define the behavior of a user alarm independently. To do this, you need to select User-Defined. You also need to open the advanced properties in the configuration. The additional parameters that are now shown can be used to define the behavior of the alarm. The Additional Information parameter allows additional information to be added to the alarm. This could be a link to a video tutorial showing how to acknowledge the alarm, or a PDF file providing detailed information about the alarm. To integrate application data in the alarm text, we use text snippets. If a temperature alarm is triggered, for example, the current temperature value can be included in the alarm text by creating a text snippet. First, you need to specify a key that will be used later to identify the text snippet in the text. Then you select the variable in the application that contains the current temperature. To assign the text snippet information to the desired alarm, we'll reference the snippet in the alarm text under Message. Now the current temperature will be included in the alarm text for a temperature high alarm. Under Alarm Mapping, it's also possible to define how the alarm should behave in the overall system. For example, you can define the reaction to the alarm. You do this by first specifying the desired alarm and then assigning it an action. If the no product alarm is active, for example, the stop reaction should be triggered. The reactions themselves are implemented in the control application. In this way, it is the reactions that define what behavior an alarm will trigger in the control application. What's the advantage of this? Suppose our project contains a whole variety of alarms, such as temperature, no product, invalid product, and more. Normally, each alarm would be handled individually in the control application. If the temperature alarm is active, the machine should lower its speed. If the saw battered alarm is active, the machine should stop and the yellow warning light should start flashing. In this situation, anytime you create a new alarm, you also have to adapt the control application accordingly. By using reactions, on the other hand, each alarm can simply be assigned the appropriate reaction. In our example, we've defined three reactions: slow down, stop, and yellow lamp. Each of these reactions is implemented in the control application. Now, if you add a new alarm, all you have to do is assign it to an existing reaction. There's no need to adapt or expand the control logic. As you can see, the MpAlarmX configuration provides many helpful possibilities and makes configuring a user alarm exceptionally quick and easy. Thanks for watching.